Hey folks, thanks for watching True Stories with me, Sherry Weens, and welcome back. So today I wanted to talk about the Paul Bernardo case. It's been, it's been about 25 years now since he was convicted. Now this man in the 1980s and 1990s, in 1988 he raped a girl. He dragged her off into some bushes and raped her just right off of the street. She survived, but there was two other girls that were kidnapped, abducted, and eventually killed by both Paul Bernardo and Karla Homolka, his wife. So they went to court. Everything was proven that it was them, and they were both convicted. Paul Bernardo, he was convicted for 25 years without parole. That 25 years is now up. Today was his hearing, and it is continuing. I'm hoping he's not going to get released. And from everything that I'm reading, it doesn't look like it will happen for him. So let's hope that he's going to stay behind bars. But they did find a shank in his room that he says he has no idea that it was put there. I don't believe that. I honestly feel like this crazy guy, was trying to probably protect himself from guards and general population inmates that probably wanted to kill him for what he did. Kristen French was 15 years old. She was abducted. For 3 days, he tortured her and raped her before he killed her with Karla Homolka. The other girl was Leslie Mahaffy. She was 14 years old in Ontario as well. Her body was dismembered, and pieces of her body were put into cement that were later dumped into a lake. So heartless, heartless man. I just want to follow with the footage that I do have for you guys, just so you can hear a little bit how that case went and a little bit from his lawyer. So I'll let you listen to that now.
23 years since his convictions in connection with the deaths of Leslie Mahaffy, Kristen French, and Tammy Homolka. But the charge that Paul Bernardo faced in court today had to do with his behavior in custody. Now, Bernardo was charged earlier this year with possession of a dangerous weapon after officials at Millhaven Penitentiary alleged they found a homemade shank in his cell fashioned out of a screw attached to a pen. He appeared in courtroom one of this Napanee courthouse today by video link, listening intently as the Crown told court it had no reasonable prospect of conviction and was withdrawing the charge. Outside court, Bernardo's lawyer, Fergus O'Connor, told reporters he's pleased with the decision.
They said in court there's no such thing as a finding of innocence, but in this case we had a very strong defense, and by withdrawing the charge, the Crown acknowledged that he wasn't going to prove his case, and that's the closest thing we can get to a finding of innocence.
O'Connor isn't denying the item found in Bernardo's cell was a shank, but if the trial were to go ahead, he says he would deny that Bernardo knew anything about it.
Our defense was primarily that he had no knowledge of it being there, and during the course of investigation, it has become clear that there was many opportunities for many other people to have placed it there, and of course, as you know, he's reviled not by just people out of jail, but by people in jail. And so the alternative that he didn't know it was there is a reasonable alternative.
Now, Paul Bernardo will be back in the public eye in less than 2 weeks now. October 17th is when he's scheduled for a hearing in front of the parole board. He's been eligible for day parole since 2015, but has constantly delayed those hearings. His lawyer, Fergus O'Connor, says that his client has been atoning for his crimes. He's been well-behaved in prison, taking programs to try and rehabilitate himself, and has even been visited by his parents behind bars. However, the likelihood of him getting parole is fairly slim, because he is a dangerous offender, and he's also the Scarborough rapist. Mark Carcassel, Global.
Now, the two girls that were kidnapped, this happened back in the 1991, so it's been a long time, but that's nonetheless to say that this guy isn't going to get out at 54 and carry on being, you know, a heinous rape, you know, serial killer. I kind of consider that serial, because had he not have been caught, I really am not sure that he would have stopped. I think he would have continued with abducting other girls and, you know, torturing and raping them until they eventually killed them too. So Karla Homolka, his wife, did get a lesser sentence because she testified against Paul Bernardo, But that's, again, I disagree with that too. I feel like she should have gotten just as much of a harsh punishment as he did. And I don't feel that she should be able to, you know, be released and stuff like that. Tell me your thoughts. What do you think about this case? And did you follow any of it? And what are your thoughts and feelings on Paul Bernardo and Karla Homolka and what they did to, you know, those two girls, Kristen French and Leslie Mahaffy? Absolutely horrible. I would love to hear your comments in the comments section. And if you enjoyed this video with me, a thumbs up would be a great support. And stay safe out there, folks. It's a crazy world, and it just seems to not be getting any better. It's getting worse. So stay safe out there. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you again next time. Bye for now.